When it comes to ensuring the health of our nation's soil, cover crops play a major role. That's why the Natural Resources Conservation Service hosts outreach events like Cover Crop Field Day. Local farmers, gardeners, and soil health enthusiasts came together to discover the cover at the NRCS Plant Materials Center in Corvallis, Oregon.
Our main focus today was cover crops and how they can be used as part of a soil health management system. We're looking at kind of some different species and varieties and how to choose those depending on what purposes you're going for, and then different aspects of managing them, how to plant them, how and when to kill them, what kind of mixes can work well, and different effects of those different types of species and mixes on soil properties.
When and how to terminate cover crops is a common challenge for growers. NRCS shared some best practices and demonstrated a new piece of equipment called a roller crimper. This machine allows farmers to kill cover crops without using chemicals, which is a huge benefit for organic farmers. The day also included presentations from the Benton Soil and Water Conservation District, showing differences in soil properties like aggregate stability, infiltration, and runoff in healthy soil compared to poor soil.
So you can see that where this gets tilled a lot, if you're paying for that irrigation water to go on the ground, you're basically throwing your money away. This should have very little runoff, but there's a little bit happening there. But in this soil, you have the water going down into the ground where you want it to be stored during our kind of dry summers.
While there are multiple challenges growers face with cover crops, the benefits are far and wide.
So cover crops, you're having living roots in the field year-round, which is feeding the soil microorganisms. You're increasing the organic matter, which is increasing the amount of water-holding capacity, basically food for those soil microorganisms. Having diverse cover crops, you're creating habitat for a broader variety of soil microorganisms, so you have more of the beneficial microorganisms that can help combat against some of those less desirable soil microorganisms. They're preventing erosion on sloping ground. They're fertilizing plants by fixing nitrogen, suppressing weeds. There's just a whole host of benefits to cover crops.
Soil quality pays. Soil health will benefit the grower. Like we said today, it might take 3 to 5 years for some of the benefits to show up, but consistently the people who have adopted cover crops and reduced tillage, they see the benefits, they see improved yield. And many of them are there because they've had reduced cropping systems that are just degraded, and they've noticed that they can't grow crops like they used to. And so soil health pays.